transition into this service of dedication, there are just a few things I would like to say. But before I say what you see on the screen, I just want to say a few words of thanks. Already noted by Donna in her prayer request was that getting to this day, just since Monday when we received our occupancy permit, involved a lot of work. Cleaning the connector, the sanctuary, so that it is spick and span, preparing all of those little details that has gone with it. So we want to thank Donna and Deb and Ted Luzzi and all of those who stepped forward and helped with cleaning and preparations. Thank you very, very much. Insert, and I just want to express my gratitude to Pam Axtell, our administrative assistant, and Pam and her husband Brian are with us today. Thank you for putting together what has been, I know, a challenge at times. We appreciate your efforts. Thank you. A few words of explanation. The service of dedication will begin with the reconsecration of this space, including the video and sound systems and the nursery. We'll get to that. The second part of today's dedication will take place on the first floor of the connector, where we will dedicate the elevator and the connector itself. A couple more. We'll proceed to the connector either by using the stairs or the elevator, and John Patrick will be playing an organ piece for us to process to. So process. Following the completion of the dedication in the connector, please proceed to the vestry for a reception that will follow. And during the reception, you're welcome to explore the connector, the ladies' parlor on the first floor, and the nursery on the second floor, but please don't stray too far because many of the spaces in the Wesley building are in the process of being painted. We don't want you to be among those who get painted. Let us join in our declaration of purpose for this day. Brothers and sisters in Christ, this is a day of rejoicing. We have come together to dedicate this building of the Main Street United Methodist Church. Let us open our hearts and minds to receive God's word with faith. May our blessed communion, born of one baptism and nurtured at one table of the Lord, become the one temple of the Holy Spirit. As we gather in love. We have a number of guests with us. The first I will just acknowledge, but you'll get a chance to hear from them later on. Elliot and Marianne Hall and Charles Hall and Tracy Hadgett, if you could all stand for us so we can see who you are. Thank you for being among us today, and we'll hopefully hear from you downstairs. We have representing our mayor and the city of Nashua, Alderman at Large, Dave, and Dave, forgive me if I mispronounce this, and it's Zan. We welcome you to say a few words on behalf of yourself or the mayor, unless you would prefer not to.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dave Tenzo. I am here on behalf of Mayor Donjes, who apologizes for not being able to be here this morning. He has sent with me a letter on his behalf, which I'd like to read to you now. Dear Pastor Colin and parishioners of the Main Street United Methodist Church, I send my deepest regrets that I'm unable to attend today's dedication ceremony. Please know that you are all in my thoughts today as you celebrate this momentous occasion. Over the past 5 years, it has been a pleasure to watch this project evolve from plan to conclusion. In many ways, the fact that the community has invested both its time and money into the Main Street United Methodist Church is symbolic of the bigger picture of what's happening in our downtown. Nashua is going through a renaissance, and I'm proud that you're all a part of it. Again, congratulations for completion of this project, and God bless the Main Street United Methodist Church going forward. Sincerely, Jim Donjes, Mayor of the City of Nashua.
Thank you, dear.
If you you were to read through the church's history, a gift to us from Jay Lawrence Hall, it is a church history that reminds us that at many momentous occasions, this congregation has wondered, do we really want to stay downtown? At least four times that I can count, that question has been raised and voted on, and each time the congregation has said, yes, we are a downtown congregation and this is where we want to stay. But the other remarkable thing about that is that once that decision was made, the congregation has always put their money and their time where their words were and recommitted to making the renovations and changes that would be necessary to moving forward into the future. And so in April of 2013, after many years in which our facilities task force explored all the various options for us as a congregation, a vote was taken at a special charge conference, and almost unanimously, the congregation said once again, yes, we are a downtown church, and we would like to continue our mission and ministry as a downtown church. But more importantly, the church also said we want to commit ourselves today to a capital campaign that would allow us to do what needs to be done into the future. Now, I suspect if any of us on that day knew what it would actually take, we probably would have said, nah, we're not going there. But we didn't know, and sometimes ignorance is bliss. And I would like to suggest that in this case, it was surely that. We immediately began to reach out to capital campaign consultants and made the decision to hire Generous Stewardship and Tom Melzoni. And that began a journey that is now in its fifth year, but one that is coming to a conclusion. In your insert, you'll find the names of all of those who have donated to the Heart of Nashua Capital Campaigns, to all those who have donated to make what we are dedicating today possible. You'll also find the names of all of those who have served as a part of the Heart of Nashua Capital Campaign teams. I'd like to begin by recognizing Paul Pedrazzani, and if you would have a stand-up, Paul. Paul has chaired both Heart of Nashua One and Heart of Nashua Growing in Faith campaign, and it has been a joyful pleasure on my part to work along with him. Stay standing. If you were on either of those executive teams or on any of the subcommittees that helped to make those committees work, could you just stand where you are, please? These are just some of the many individuals who are a part of our capital campaign process and who made it possible for us to raise upwards now of $1.7 million just out of this congregation. And for all of you, I am very grateful. Let's give them a hand. I was very pleased when Tom Melzoni indicated that he would be able to be with us today. Tom served us both in the first and second capital campaign, was a part of that vision that we grasped at the first leadership summit back in September of 2013, and guided us faithfully along the way. And I've asked Tom if he would share a few words with you.
Pastor. Thank all of you. What a magnificent miracle. I remember a few of you said a few years ago it would take a miracle. Isn't it wonderful that one was sent? And on this day of Pentecost, we celebrate the power of the Holy Spirit and the power that allowed you to be able to do something extraordinary. I do not know of a congregation anywhere in the United States who had more heart and who has more faith, more willingness, more just let's get her done attitude. Thank you. And for the Rock of Rocks, Pastor Rich, from a very steady, I've never known Rich to be excited, just steady, just solid, secure, sound, and his leadership has been the guiding force through all of this to help us when it was looking difficult, to help us when we were overly excited, to help us be here today. So the theme that we spent some time on a few years ago, the heart of Nashua, truly, truly, truly was the right theme. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
We have not done this in a vacuum, but we have done it with support of our district and conference, and it is a pleasure for me to welcome our district superintendent, Reverend Jim McPhee, who will share a few words with you of his journey with us along this path.
Thank you, Rock. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Good morning. I am blessed to be with you today. It's such a great day of celebration, and pleased to be invited. Thank you. I just want to say, first of all, bring greetings from our bishop. Bishop is going to be with you for the big anniversary in September. Not able to be here today, but greetings from him on this special day. My own experience of church buildings is that whether we intend or not, they often express something very important about who we are. That is, who our community, how we perceive God working with us and among us and on our behalf. And what's been described about your process to decide to really remain planted here in the heart of Nashua expresses that you have had a heart for Nashua, and that you express in so many ways that sense of God's purposefulness among you in this community, with compassion and love, with hope, and with just a sense of tangible presence and witness and ministry. So I congratulate you. This is a beautiful thing to celebrate today, but it's also a beautiful witness of your ministry in this community and your sense of God's purpose among you to continue to flourish and to be such an integral part of this place. So thank you, and thanks be to God.
Another of our partners along the way, has been the United Methodist Foundation of New England. Back in 2015, when we were just rolling along with a lot of steam behind us, they had the good wisdom of putting the brakes on for us. Thank you for doing that. It didn't feel like a thank you moment at the time. It was frustrating, it was disappointing, and I think we all experienced a certain amount of disappointment at that time, but it allowed us some space to do some things with the second capital campaign that have brought tremendous fruitfulness to our ability to be where we are today. And so I would like to both thank the United Methodist Foundation of New England for putting the brakes on, but when the time came to step forward with an offer of the loan that allowed us to complete this project, they were there for that as well. I welcome Executive Director Jim Menser, who is here to share a few words with us as well.
me back to New England in 2011. We rented a condominium in Hudson. Now, I can remember one of the first times we were visiting churches and we decided we would come to Main Street United Methodist Church in Nashua, and we drove down Main Street and we couldn't find you. That is no longer a problem. I can remember in 2013, the conference anxiously awaited the outcome of the vote of this church. Would you stay? Would you move? I won't suggest to you that there was some bookmaking going, but I suspect there was a bet or two on the side. And to be honest, to my surprise and yet my delight, you voted apparently a fourth time to stay. Thanks be to God for your decision. The foundation is honored to have provided the financial footing to make this dream happen, to make this miracle happen. It is part of the work that we do. We are often seen as an organization that helps churches manage money, but it's probably not as well known that we currently have loaned out about $6 million to churches all across New England and to the annual conference. We actually have loaned money to the annual conference for their new building as well. So on behalf of the board of directors of the foundation, on behalf of the staff, we are honored to have been a partner with you. And I'd be remiss if I said, and didn't ask Dan Hudson to stand. Dan is our loan officer. He did all the hard work, folks. He's the one who put on the brakes, but in the long run, he's the one I think that really has helped this project to come to fruition. So while I thank you for being included in this honor of this dedication today, please know that Dan is the one who deserves the credit. Thank you.
Of the foundation for many years, and it was very much a part of his journey and history. And if you look in the chapel, you'll find some beautiful glass bookends that were given by the foundation to Phil at the time he retired from the board, and which his family has graciously passed along to us. And so they are beautiful, and please take note of them. So, 2013. The work of the Facilities Task Force is over. The future lies with a Renovations Committee, although the name would eventually change to a Building Committee. Who would we look to direct that effort? Someone suggested a guy by the name of Ted Muzzy. Didn't really know Ted at the time. I didn't know then, and I still don't know how to correctly spell his last name. Is it Z before S or S before Z? I have to think about it every time. But clearly, he was the right person at the right time. He brought both experience in other building projects. He brought a commitment to the Main Street United Methodist Church. He brought his leadership skills in directing individuals to begin and see through a project that has taken us 5 years to complete. And so I would like to first of all acknowledge Ted and give him a moment to say a few words, but also I would like to invite members of the building committee to stand where you are. Pastor Dave was a part of that, but he's down in the counting room, he's a multi-purpose guy. So let us express our thanks to these
that I have been able, and I have been blessed to meet a great group of people. And I mean, they are a great group of people, not only of the building committee and the renovation committee, but all of our people that did the actual work. Gary Thomas, North Point, the owner, great, great person. He provided us with a lot of gifts that you probably don't see, from concrete, that if we could afford it, he helped pay for it, to a flagpole that was near and dear to Paul Curtis's heart. We were going to cut that from the project, but they came towards us and said, no, we'll give you the flagpole. So I want to thank North Point, Gary, and all the subs. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to Scott, who is from North Point, to say a few words on behalf of everyone from North Point.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So, a little over 4 years ago, we first met with the building committee to discuss the concept of joining this church and the Wesley building with a connector. Since our first meeting, much has changed and much has been accomplished. But one thing has been constant, and that is the determination of Main Street United Methodist Church to make its vision a reality. I speak on behalf of everyone in North Point when I say it has been an honor to take part in your vision in the four-year journey. I say 4 years, I know we've been saying five. North Point unfortunately missed out on the first year. But to take part in the four-year journey to completion of an extremely challenging list of accomplishments. Since our first meeting in April of 2014, we have worked through a number design concepts, changes, and revisions. Budget reviews of value engineering, city and state approvals, and of course, fundraising efforts. As a result of these efforts, the church completed hazardous materials testing and removal throughout all existing facilities, including the storefront building, which I'm sure you all remember. The church completed the demolition of the storefront. The church de-leaded and painted all exterior trim and installed a new roof, stabilizing the exterior of Wesley Building for years to come. The church upgraded the electrical service to Wesley Building in anticipation of the connector building and the addition of a new elevator. The church installed all new underground utilities from Main Street to Wesley Building in advance of the city improvements of the sidewalk. The church decommissioned removed an abandoned oil tank from the front yard of the property. The church added commercial grade dehumidification and ultraviolet odor control in the main church basement. The church completed a new roof on the main sanctuary building above us. The church completed the connector itself, including a new casket size elevator, several new ADA compliant access ramps, both inside and outside the building, video surveillance and a broader Wi-Fi coverage, a new toddler toilet area in the nursery, and a new parking lot with dumpster enclosure and properly functioning drainage. The church stabilized and rebuilt the existing granite steps to the front of the church building. The church restored and painted the plaster finishes in the narthex and the entire sanctuary. The church restored and painted, you said that already. There's so many accomplishments. The church added complete fire suppression and fire alarm systems throughout the entire complex. The church added air conditioning in the sanctuary for days like today. But last, but certainly not least, the church has created a beautiful new connection to the Nashua community. With a welcoming new plaza, granite benches recycled from church foundation stones, salvaged during demolition, and landscaping that will be the pride of Main Street. So congratulations to Main Street Union Methodist Church for making your vision a reality.
Thank you.
this church building, minus the basement, in 1868, was dedicated to the glory of God on July 22nd, 1868. July 22nd of this year happens to be on a Sunday, and we're going to have a throwback service in celebration of that. Over the course of 150 years, much has changed in this sanctuary, and I'm sure it's been rededicated, reconsecrated on a number of occasions. But never has it looked quite like this, with the combination of the old and the new, the combination of wooden pews that have been with us for a long time, with new technologies like a state-of-the-art sound system where one can walk around with an iPad and do whatever needs to be done, and the visual system that allows us to see and experience worship in ways that words could not do alone. I would like to first of all acknowledge the gift of the visual projectors and screens from the Clark Pounder family, and Ian, if you and your daughter would just stand for a moment. Ian and Brenda approached me back in June of last year after they had returned north from their usual stay in Florida to say, wouldn't it be nice if we had screens and projectors so that we could see as well here as we can at the church we worship in Florida. And that began a conversation. We didn't know at the time that it would eventually be given in memory of Brenda. But her memory is with us today, as it always will be. And every time I look at the images on these screens, I will think of Brenda and her presence with us. So thank you to the Clark Pounder family. Back in January, I had the wonderful opportunity to celebrate the wedding of Nani Negulono's daughter and son-in-law. And as Nani has introduced us from her Nigerian culture to love gifts and processing forward to present gifts in special occasions. And the request was made at that time that the gifts that were given become part of the cost of the new sound system in memory of Nani's husband, Christopher Samuel O. Ngumonu. We have never had the opportunity to meet Christopher, but his presence is with us as we celebrate today. We give thanks to Nani and her family. So I would just like to ask, we have a few members of the Ngumonu family with us, if you could all stand together today. I've asked our district superintendent, Jim McPhee, to offer the prayer of dedication for the sanctuary and our new technologies.
Let's unite our hearts and lift our spirits in prayer. O God, as King Solomon reminded the Israelites when dedicating the temple of old, so too may we be reminded that even heaven and the highest heaven cannot contain you, much less this house built with human hands. Nevertheless, we recognize that this is a sacred space where many, through the past 150 years, have experienced your presence, have been inspired and challenged to live the gospel. We're grateful that we can reconsecrate this sanctuary to your glory. May the words that are spoken here be clearly heard by many, thanks to the gift of a sound system provided to amplify our words of worship and proclamation. May our eyes likewise feast upon the images on these screens that speak to us in ways that words alone cannot. We are grateful for the generosity of the Clark Pounder and Ngumonu families who have made these gifts possible. And we give thanks for Brenda and Christopher, whose memories continue to bless us. May this sanctuary be a sacred place long into the future that lies ahead for this congregation. For we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord.
At some point in this process, the question arose, would it be possible for us to move our nursery from the first floor of the church to the second floor, now that we will have an opportunity to get to the second floor of the Wesley building in a quick and easy fashion. And there are those
can you record this for a second? I need to run
together
just
to
keep it focused on the back. Be right back.
And have some images in front of you that show the nursery being used this morning for the very first time. There's that cute toilet. I've asked our lay leader, Susan McDonald, who's also been a member of the building committee, to offer our prayer of dedication this morning for the new nursery.
Let us pray. O God, we remember the words of Jesus who said, "Let the children come to me, for of such is the kingdom of God." And we are grateful for this new nursery space so lovingly created by caring members of this congregation. We pray that it will prove to be a safe and inviting place for our children to experience the love of Christ. May they find a church to be a fun place where they can learn and grow. And may the parents who entrust their children to our care have the confidence that their children are loved and valued as beloved children of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Now it's time to move. I know you've been sitting a long time, but we want to take this opportunity to move our dedication from this place to the connector. Accessibility in every way, including an elevator. And as we began to work with the architect and then North Point Construction, things began to take shape, and it had to be a particular kind of elevator. And Donna Swanson, the chair of our trustees, is going to share with the Hall family and with you just some of the specifics about our elevator.
It's here. It will easily hold the whole Sunday school class, all the Sunday school classes. We demonstrated that this morning. It also will hold a full casket, and the people go along with it. One of the things that we needed to have in the elevator was an emergency phone number. So when I contacted Fairpoint about having that put in, they said, "Oh, well, is there a particular phone number that you would like?" And at first I said, no, John, I think it's, I said, no, wait a minute, I got an idea. He said, okay, fine, what? I said, it needs to be 4255. Now, for all of you looking at your guns, going, what does 4255 mean? That spells hall. If you look at your phones, it spells hall. So the emergency number for the phone, when it shows up in emergency, it's 598-4255. No. It does not call you church. We do know for sure that it works, because Joe found himself locked in the elevator not long ago. We won't tell you how that happened. One of the things that we had to decide about that elevator was what sort of finish was going to be on the interior walls. And the first thing that I looked at when I started looking at finishes, the only thing that jumped out and waved to me was a finish called oiled olive wood. The olive wood has a huge connection to our Christian faith. It's the tree with the highest endurance and fruitful capacity. It was an olive leaf that the dove brought back to Noah to show that the flood waters had receded. It's also the olive branch that's offered as a sign of peace and goodwill to people. So it just seemed natural that the oiled olive wood, that the bead finish that was appropriate for the inside of our elevator. Phil and Betty Hall were examples of strength and goodwill. Their lives and commitment to each other as well as to this church and the community will be honored and remembered as we use this gift given in their memory. So, I have a replica of the plaque that will be mounted to give to the Hall family. It says, this elevator is placed in memory of Philip and Betty Hall with gratitude to God for their labor of love and building others up in the ministry of the United Methodist Church, May 20th. 2018.
Phil Hall was very much a part of this project from the very beginning, sharing his wisdom, sharing his insight, helping us to make some challenging decisions. I had always envisioned that Phil would be the very first person to use the elevator. That was my hope and prayer. It was not to happen, and for that I have my regrets, but nonetheless I am grateful that on this day we can dedicate this elevator in memory of Phil and Betty, and we're grateful to have two of the three Hall children with us to celebrate, and this time Charlie will share a few words with you.
Thank you. So I'm here representing really our parents, but our whole family, and our sister Sue, who lives on Washington State, could not make it. She'll be here in July, so I'll make sure that she comes by and sees everything. But at the service, Pastor Rich mentioned that our grandfather wrote a history of Methodism in Nashua, probably about 1980. I tried to find it. I got it at the house over. I couldn't put my hand on it and write it, but I know you have a copy or two around. I think it's probably time that, and he'd be much appreciative if somebody would take that project and update it. So a lot has happened since 1980 here on Main Street. But certainly, speaking for our parents and especially our father, I know he was thrilled that Main Street United Methodist Church decided to stay on Main Street. That was very important to him. And he was involved with the project up till he couldn't any longer, but he knew what was going on. And we're very pleased to be involved with the elevator as well as the HVAC. In fact, we're just up in, people shouldn't be here. You should be up in the steeple, because that's where all the nice mechanical equipment is. Somebody made the comment, boy, it looks really nice. And I said, I could show you my financials and show the job and show you how much time my guys and material spend on it. But it's all for a great cause. And we're certainly pleased to represent the Hall family here today. So thank you all.
doors of the elevator are open, locked, so they won't close you in and you won't have to use the emergency number, but now that you know what it is, that's good. But let us pause to give thanks to God for this gift. Oh God, we give thanks on this special day for this elevator that will provide access for many people who otherwise might not have the ability to experience the worship and educational opportunities that are provided in the sanctuary and Wesley building. We are grateful for Phil and Betty Hall, in whose memory this elevator is dedicated, remembering their faithful service to this congregation over the course of many decades. Thank you for the generosity of the Hall family that has made this possible. May the gift of accessibility allow us to reach many with the good news of Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. Now I invite you to turn in your program to the dedication for the connector itself. And our district superintendent, Jim Fee, and Susan McDonald, and I will be passing the microphone. Please join in with the bold print words. Dear friends, now that we have completed building, let us dedicate this connecting building and rejoice in its holy use. To the glory of God who has called us by grace, to the honor of Jesus Christ who loved us and gave himself for us, to the praise of the Holy Spirit who illumines and sanctifies us.
We dedicate this place